Cupra Born stronger and better than Volkswagen ID.3. The Cupra Born is the first entirely electric vehicle produced by the Spanish manufacturer Cupra, and it's a fantastic one. The new Cupra Born, closely related to the Volkswagen ID.3, which received 5 stars overall, has a lot going for it. But which electric vehicle is the better option? A more sporty version of the Volkswagen ID.3, which maintains largely the same range and performance, but features an interior with significant modifications. It basically borrows all of its technology from the Volkswagen ID.3. Which of these should you buy then, the Cupra Born or the Volkswagen ID.3? Or does it not really matter which one you choose? Hey guys, welcome back to Tech Electric. In today's video, we are going to compare Cupra Born with the Volkswagen ID.3. What do you guys think is going to be the winner? Just stay with us till the end of the video so you don't miss out on any of this information. And before we proceed, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell symbol so you don't miss out on any of our wonderful videos in the future. And let's get started. Volkswagen's family of ID.3 Pro Performance Vehicles. The incumbent winner of the award for Best Small Electric Car from various publications possesses a diverse set of strengths, one of which is a range that is superior to the norm and gives customers a wide variety of options. Cain and Abel both died, the daughters of Anne Boleyn, the Gallagher brothers, Liam and Noel. There have been a great number of instances of sibling competition over the course of the years, and the world of automobiles is just as likely as any other industry to have this type of competition, particularly when it comes to the Volkswagen Group. The most recent illustration of this can be seen in the competition that's recently begun between the Volkswagen ID.3 and the nearly comparable Cupra Born, which has just recently arrived. It shares its underpinnings with the ID.3, but the Cupra has had time to work on ways of distinguishing its first electric vehicle from its stablemate and, you'd hope, iron out some of the wrinkles that existed in the ID.3. While it does share its underpinnings with the ID.3, Cupra's had some time to work on ways of distinguishing itself. Both of the competitors continue to have the appearance of having sprung from the same egg, but the Born appears to be the more athletic choice, not just in terms of appearance, but also in terms of how it drives. They share the same 201 horsepower electric motor and 58 kilowatt hour usable capacity battery, and the prices for the mid-range trims that offer here are extremely comparable to one another. Is the ID.3 still the best little electric vehicle that money can buy, or has Cupra found a way to improve upon what was already an extremely well-rounded package? Driving. Performance, ride, handling, refinement. When it comes to acceleration, the competitors are very closely matched. The Born can go from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 6.9 seconds, while the slightly heavier ID.3 is only a tenth of a second behind. Given that they both have identical power outputs, it should not come as a surprise that they are so closely matched. Both models have more than sufficient performance for a family hatchback, with the ability to respond smoothly and firmly to prods of the accelerator pedal at lower speeds, as well as having plenty of reserve power for passing slower vehicles or getting up to highway speeds. If that isn't quick enough for you, you can buy a more powerful version of the Born called the e-Boost that decreases the time it takes to go from 0 to 62 miles per hour by 0.7 seconds. At least for the time being, there's not a version of the ID.3 that's more powerful. In either vehicle, you will not feel any vibrations through the seat, steering wheel, or pedals, which contributes to the overall feeling of calm and relaxation you'll have in the majority of scenarios when you're driving. There's also very little noise to cope with. However, the Born is noticeably less noisy when traveling at highway speeds. Even though the ID.3 rides on 18-inch wheels, as opposed to the optional 20s that are on the Born test vehicle, you will notice that there's a slight increase in the amount of wind noise that can be heard around the windscreen. In addition, there's a slight increase in the amount of road noise that can be heard. Having a sneaking suspicion that the standard panoramic glass roof on the ID.3 isn't helping matters either, as it likely makes the interior a bit more of an echo chamber. On the other hand, because it has a stiffer suspension than the Born, you're more likely to hear it banging away as it travels over uneven roads. The sound of the optional heat pump, which hums along like a motor while you're attempting to warm up the interior of the car on chilly days, is something else that you might hear if you're traveling at lower speeds in either vehicle. Both of the candidates offer a handling experience that is satisfactory for the vast majority of users. Neither one's perfect when it comes to having fun, but the ID.3 has a lot of grips and is quite composed around turns, with just the right amount of lean. The Born makes a more deliberate attempt to provide the driver with a more enjoyable experience by providing even more grip, tighter body control, and more precise steering. Even while there's not much of a departure from the way the ID.3 was set up, it's likely that more enthusiastic drivers will be drawn to it because of the improved responsiveness and calmness. However, it's not an electric hot hatch in any way. Thankfully, the Born was able to show its playful side on back roads without making it too many sacrifices in terms of the comfort it provides on a daily basis. Its stronger suspension helps it feel more controlled at faster speeds than the ID.3, which does not settle as quickly over larger bumps. However, due to its more forgiving low-speed ride and lighter pedals, the ID.3 is the option that is most conducive to relaxation. This is especially true for individuals who spend most of their time in towns and cities. If you have to be concerned about your range, it's only natural that you won't feel very relaxed. With the Born and the ID.3, you have your choice between three different battery capacities, ranging from 45 kilowatt hours to 77 kilowatt hours. Even the smallest one can officially cover more than 200 miles on a full charge, but if you routinely do longer excursions, a 77 kilowatt hour choice will be the better bet because it has an official range of 340 miles. The Born took the lead with an estimated 191-mile real-world range based on its energy consumption on the test route, with the ID.3 trailing slightly behind on 185 miles. Both the 58-kilowatt-hour test cars promised to cover around 260 miles between the charges, but it was the Born that took the lead with an estimated 191-mile real-world range. When looking at cost, EV database reports that the Cupra Born in its 58-kilowatt-hour V2 configuration is the more affordable option at roughly $41,118. The MSRP of the Volkswagen ID.3 Pro Performance is $42,090, which is an increase of around $1,000. The ID.3's cabin is noisier than the Born's due to wind, made worse by the panoramic glass roof, while the Born's suspension makes a thumping noise over rougher terrain. The Cupra's driving experience is heightened by the addition of sport seats and copper accents. While the Cupra Born's optional adaptive dampers raise the drive sensation and improve control over rougher surfaces, the two vehicles otherwise deliver quite similar rides in terms of both control and agility. The Cupra Born's preferable to the ID.3 because of its sportier exterior and general appearance, as well as the fact that it can be equipped with an optionally more powerful motor and battery combination and e-boost to cut that extra time off of acceleration. We prefer the Cupra Born to its Volkswagen ID.3 sibling, though this may be mostly a question of personal taste. And that's going to do it for today's video, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure you click on the like button and share it with all your friends and family. If you have any questions or comments for us, please share them with us in the comment space below. We always love to hear your feedback. Do you own either of these vehicles, or have you driven either of them ever? Let us know what your thoughts are and if you have a preference. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel where you'll see even more of our incredible videos. You can also check out other videos that have been specially selected just for you. One more thing, please make sure you hit that bell icon on your way out the door. That way you are always notified of all of our latest updates to our channel. We're always putting new stuff up, and we look forward to sharing it with you. Hey, thanks again for spending time out of your busy day to be with us today, and we look forward to seeing you in our next video. Have a great rest of your day, and thanks for watching.